you want to be successful in your life? Your obvious answer being, who doesn't? Many people will listen to several influential speakers. Many have spent their lives researching about that secret ingredient that will ultimately help you to break the spark and climb the ladder of success. There have been several debates on whether it is patience or passion, honesty or perseverance, efforts or vigilance. According to a wonderful book written by Grant Cardone, the answer is the 10X rule. So, what is the 10X rule all about? In the term 10X, X represents your current performance. The 10 and the X together refer to a principle that states to truly succeed, you need to apply the 10 times effort that you are currently giving in to accomplish your goal. This will compel you to take massive amount of actions and will elevate you to success. The 10X rules, if followed meticulously, will not only make you successful but will also provide the mindset of one. So now let's dive into the how and what the power of 10X rules can be procured.
Why 10X? The 10X rule aims to help you establish the right levels of action and thinking that will guarantee success and ensure that you continue to operate at the right levels for the rest of your life. In addition to that, it will dissolve all of your fears, boost your self-courage, increase self-dependency, and make you more punctual by eliminating procrastination. It will help you commit something up to an extent that all your insecurities will be destroyed. Knowing what the 10X rule has to offer, it does all expand our knowledge and keep some important aspects in mind while following the 10X rule.
Now, let us understand what success is and what should be our approach towards it. Well, success can be defined as the degree of measure of actions required to reach a specific target or a goal. Two points to keep in mind to get success are: the first point, success is your duty. Many people just hang around here and there waiting for success to knock their doors. But in reality, it's the exact opposite. We need to knock on success's doors through our positivity, through our hard work and consistency, and only then can we achieve success. Therefore, success is our duty, our obligation, and our responsibility. The second point, there is no shortage of success. Many people think success to be a commodity or a resource, but in reality, it's not that. No shortage of success could ever be created. It is media who has propagated the message that success is like a seesaw. If one person wins, the other has to lose. But in reality, it's not this. All of us can win only and only if we work indefatigably and accept success as our duty.
You need to quit lying to yourself. Many people provide a variety of justifications for what they are not able to achieve. They even try to lie to themselves by minimizing how much success means to them. It is all right when you want something and it doesn't come to fruition. It will compel you to work harder the next time. Many people even rely upon luck to achieve success, as they think that some successful CEO of a multinational company ended up in the right school, the right university, and ended up making the right connections. This isn't at all the reality.
People who typically succeed are the ones who take full responsibility for what they are, what success they have created, and also for failing to do the same. People who portray themselves to the world as crybabies, whiners, great at creating success, as it is extremely hard to take massive amounts of actions, and if you don't take responsibility and to stay positive when you are complaining. If you are able to internalize everything happened to you are not the result of your so-called luck or happenstance, everything around you will manifest the way it has only because of you. Doing so will innately increase and enhance your ability to find and create solutions for your problems, which will indirectly provide you with success. Consider yourself as both the problem and the solution, rather than the victim who posed someone or something else as the problem, and solution doesn't come into the picture at all.
Degrees of action. This part of section answers the question that how much action is required to achieve success. Understanding and calculating the right amount of action is more important than your ideas, concepts, and business plans. The 4 degrees of actions, which are the options which you have to select, are: A. Do nothing. B. Retreat. C. Take smaller amounts of action. D. Take massive amounts of action. Different people take different degrees of action in different fields and areas of their life.
First degree of action, doing nothing. Interesting degree of action, as the title suggests, people don't take actions in order to move forward, grow and control as an individual. People who adopt this degree are probably the ones who have quit on their dreams and have accepted what comes their way. Even though how absurd it sounds, in fact, doing nothing requires a lot of energy. All levels do in their own ways. People in this group are found spending energy and time justifying the situations, which require as much energy as the previous levels. People in this degree exhibit boredom, lethargy, complacency, and lack of purpose. It takes energy to lose your job due to lack of productivity. It takes efforts to subsist as an individual with no success or achievement. Second degree of action, retreat. Retreaters are those who take actions in reverse, probably in order to escape from the negative results that, according to them, is the consequence of putting in efforts. They never retreat due to the failure that has impacted them. It is the impression of failure that makes them retreat. And after that, they will spend as much action in justifying the retreat that successful people will put in succeeding.
Third degree of action, normal levels of action. The majority of the population selects this degree of action. This creates a middle class and is dangerous because it is considered ethical. The people from this section do not create problems for themselves or others until the situation is predictable and steady. The people from this section of the society do not get substantial attention, as it is widely accepted and it is required for themselves to catapult themselves to success. Fourth degree of action, massive amounts of action. In this level of action, you need to commit yourself to success and make it your duty, obligation, and responsibility. You need to work as your life depends on it. As you move on your 10x journey, you'll find yourself creating problems. But do not worry, it is the part of the process. Upon adopting this type of action, you'll find yourself to be able to materialize your goals. It it is crucial for you to break free of the socially accepted mediocrity.
Let everything that was previously discussed seep in. What you have just witnessed is the key to success laid down on a gold platter. But wait, there is more to it. There is more to the 10x mechanism. Grant Cardin one himself said, until you are alive, either you will be working to accomplish your goals and dreams, or you will be used as a resource to accomplish someone else's. The two parts to the 10x mechanism are outstanding efforts and audacious goals. Today, we have finished the first part. We'll be soon back to unveil the second part too, which focuses on what to do to form a perfect goal. Until then, we leave you to think and absorb whatever we have learned today. Have a great day. Thank you.
Gandhiji's non-violence was the seed of our freedom's tree. Don't be patriotic for one day. Be patriotic from the day one. So let's arise for the national anthem. Assembly Saudhan!
Jana Gana Mana Adhinayaka Jaya Hind Bharat Bhagya Vidhata Punjab Sindh Gujarat Maratha Dravida Utkala Vanga Vindhya Himachala Yamuna Ganga Uchala Jaladhi Taranga Tava Shubha Name Jage तव शुभ आशीष मांगे गाहे तव जय गाथा जन गण मंगल दायक जय हे भारत भाग्य विधाता जय हे जय हे जय हे जय 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 हे
Assembly wish Ram. Be silent and work hard. Let the success make the noise. Now I invite Madhur Bhai for today's point to socho.
Namaste. Today I'll tell you a short story depicting a superb metaphorical exposition of the level of preparedness. Years ago, a farmer owned a land along the Atlantic seacoast. He constantly advertised for hiring hands, but most people were reluctant to work on farms across the Atlantic. They dreaded the awful storms that raged across the Atlantic that wreaked havoc on both crops and buildings. As the farmer interviewed applicants, he received a steady stream of refusals. Finally, a little man, well past his middle age, approached the farmer. Are you a good farming hand? Asked the farmer. Well, I can sleep when the wind blows, answered the little man. Although puzzled with the answer, the farmer, desperate for help, hired him. The little man worked well around the farm. He kept busy from dawn to dusk, and the farmer also felt satisfied with the man's work. One night, then the wind started blowing violently. The farmer jumped out of bed, grabbed a lantern, and rushed next door to the hiring hand's sleeping quarters. He shook the little man and yelled, "Get up, a storm is coming. Tie things down before they blow away." The little man rolled over and firmly said, "No, sir, I told you, I can sleep when the wind blows." The farmer was outraged with the answer and was tempted to fire the little man on the spot. But instead, he hurried out to prepare for the incoming storm. To his amazement, he found out that all the haystacks were tied down with tarpaulin. All the cows were placed safely in their shed, and the chickens in their coop. All the doors had been barred and all the shutters had been sealed. Everything was tied down. There was nothing that could blow away. The farmer now understood what his hiring hand meant to say. He then returned to bed to sleep while the winds blew. When you are prepared spiritually, mentally, and physically, there is nothing to be afraid of. Can you sleep when the winds blow in your life? In the above story, the hired hand was able to sleep while the winds blew because he secured the farm against the winds. The story then goes on to talk about trials and tribulations in life. If we can truly understand, accept, and implement the principles that have been learned by us, then we will truly experience security, joy, and peace from within. And we'll be able to sleep while the wind blows. So ask yourself this question. Can you sleep when the wind blows? Point to Socha for today. Thank you.
Thank you, Madhur Bhai, for sharing wonderful points with us. We started this assembly with a simple hello, but now we are ending it with a complicated goodbye. I thank our music team, our technical team, all performers, last but not the least, our beautiful audience. Now let's invite music team to end this assembly with a beautiful exit song.